गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, विल कंटिन्यू द 12th स्टैंडर्ड इकोनॉमिक्स चैप्टर 8 इंटरनेशनल इकोनॉमिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इन दैट नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज दैट सार्क, दैट इज साउथ एशियन एसोसिएशन फॉर द रीजनल कोऑपरेशन. सो दिस वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड 8th डिसंबर 1985. द मेन एम ऑफ दिस सार्क इज टू इम्प्रूव द social and economical and cultural development within their Asia, South Asian countries. So in that time, who are the members means Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan, Sri Lanka. In April 2007, Afghanistan has become the 8th member of this association. The SAARC secretariat was in the established in the Kathmandu, Nepal. 16th January 1987 it was established. The first meeting of SAARC was in the Dhaka. 1985 it was a meet. SAARC meeting once in a 2 years la rendu varshathukku oru thara meeting, once in a 2 years they have a meeting. Recently 20th SAARC summit was hosted by Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka vandu 2018 la they have conducted the one meeting. What were these are the members, their country's flag. Next, what will be the object of this SAARC in the sense, according to the article 1 of a charter, SAARC in or article angledan or rules and regulation, so that is what article of charter SAARC. So object of this first one is to promote the welfare of the people. South Asian la irukkira standard of living, quality life of improvement should be there. Second one, cultural, their tradition has to be improved. Third one is self reliance, whatever the needs, basic needs of their own country, they have to produce them. Adha avangalukku thevayanadhu avangale produce padha self reliance. Next, mutual trust between the countries in the terms of a trade or in the business dealings, a trust should be there. Next, to promote the collaboration of the social, economic, cultural, technical, scientific field, if they achieved anything means that has to be shared among these members. Next, strengthen the cooperation between the nation, international level, avangaludaiya members. Next, regional organization, international level, similar aim should be with the other country also should be there. Next, function of a SAARC and the main cooperation, as I said, cooperation between their countries. Next, prevention of a problem, any problem creates mean they, the SAARC will become the middleman and problem and dispute and the problem then dispute. Okay, that they will solve the problems. Next, they'll make a strong relation between the member country and any in the member country, if any poverty is there, mean they have to remove that poverty and make them to help the progress in economic growth. Last, prevention of terrorism acts, if it's there, mean they will prevent that country, or if their country have any terrorist act, mean severe action they will take. Next, achievement of SAARC. So this SAARC first one is SAPTA, that is a SAARC preferential trade agreement. That means any the member country kulla trade if it's means tariff, that is a tax reduction irukla illa tax illami irukla import they will can do. Second one is that second technical committees, that means communication, education, health, agriculture, population, rural development, scientific and technology, and also tourisms. If it's any there means one country to another country mutual understanding la they will have visa illama in the country polam namba country na oror country ku vandu visa illama polam vera ticket vechina that they can with the mutual understanding between the country they will adopt this one. Next, SAARC has established 3-tier mechanism, that is they have to improve the standard of living of the people. For that, what they have to do, they have to reduce the poverty. That program should be made by them, and that program should be implemented to the, all the member country. Next, SAARC has agriculture informations to produce a more agriculture, or harvest should be more. The in that agriculture field, fishery and also forestry. Next is South Asian Development Fund, SADF, has developed to increase the infrastructure in the countries, member countries. It has a 3% the improvement in the last 30 years, it has shown. Next, we'll go for the ASEAN, that is the Association of Southeast Asians. So, this was established in the 8th August 1967 in the Bangkok. It has a 5 original members, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines, Singapore and Thailand. It has a 6 dialogue members. Who and all will be there in that means China, Japan, India, South Korea, New Zealand, Australia will be the dialogue. And FTA, that means a free trade should be between the countries. Any tax should be reduced or without tax also they can make between the country with the understanding of the that countries. This ASEAN's main aim into establish the, that means you can, the lifeblood of this ASEAN means they have to collaborate the international trade, FTA, they have to make it, free trade policy they have to make to its member countries. So it has a main aim to macroeconomic policy, that means country level growth should be there, the macroeconomic they will take. Government members of the country's highest form, and the members on the representative of each government member should be there. So ASEAN meeting 3 years once they will conduct. In the members ministry they will appoint, that ministry members only will be decision makers. India relationship with the ASEAN is started from 1992, the India and ASEAN as a partnership, and also it has a dialogue members, and as a it has benefited of exporting with a lower cost, freight charge cost with the low cost it has benefited. And the objective of these are the countries with the national flag they are given. Next, objective of ASEAN means a declaration of aims. First one is accelerate means give the boost for the economic growth among the members. Second, peaceful relationship should be there between the country, and also they have a knowledge will be shared in the field of a public sector auditing, anything is there means that knowledge should be shared between the countries. Next, they will have a research training, if it's they have a research education among the members, anything is there, that training also given by the SAARC to each member country. Next, we'll go for the function of ASEAN. In that, the movement of goods from one place to other place, European country, that also the mutual understanding they will make with a less tariff tax. And also it provide a free access of marketing, one member to another member, advertising all over its members over there. Next, improve the business competition among the international level so that it can reduce the gap between the member countries. Next is it creates a investment opportunity. But the friendly relation means one country to another country they will start a business international level. Okay. Next, we'll go for the BRICS. Asian experienced great crisis in the year. It has helped a lot in the trade cycle 1997. That it has helped to its member country. That we can. Next, BRICS. So it has a members, 5 members, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. Originally it has a BRIC, B-R-I-C-K. After that South Africa came, then only it has started BRICS, S added to it. In the 2000, first it was started 2001. After the 2010, South Africa it was started. Then only it has made name change B-R-I-C, then the B-R-I-C-S it has made it. And since 2001, it has achieved many things. BRIC have a meeting will be held annually. South Africa hosted the 10th BRIC. And that means meeting South Africa in 2018. And what the objective means to grow field will be trade, issues in a problem, if anything, they will solve. And also share the prosperity, peace among the country. Security should be there. Next, you can see the members, that members in the flag they given. It headquarters in the Shanghai, China. New Development Bank was started on base of these all together. And they established the, and also it has established a development between the countries. And Moscow, BRIC submitted the Moscow and South Africa host a 10th conference. Moscow la vandu South Africa la 10th conference, adhu meeting held. John Berg in July 2018, one mark they may ask. India has also conducted a 4th meeting or 8th meeting. That is the 4th meeting 2012, 8th meeting in 2016, India also has conducted the meeting, hosted the meeting. Next, here you can, it has a 21% world GDP past 15 years. And 43% of world population, BRIC, in the country, all population, world 43% they have. So it has a reserve, World Bank reserve, it also have a reserves of a dollar level of 4.4 trillion it has. Then what will be objective of BRICS means, cooperation as all the association, same thing it also have. And one more, they have a, other than dollar, they are considered, they wanted to use the other currency for the circulation. Increase the regional cooperation between the country, their main motto. Next, function of a BRICS. First one is promote means they want to implement or improve the or give the advice for the UN Security Council. And also they have a South Asian framework to improvement of a social economical growth. And it acts as a bridge or agent between the developing country and developed countries. Instead of WTO, World Trade Organization, Badila, BRICS also work among these countries. In the among the agriculture policy making also, they will be the members. And it has recommended or contributed many gain in climatic condition should be controlled. That also they will give advice. And also it disseminates the exchange platform between cooperation between the countries also. If any disputes, they will solve the problem. It acts as a middleman, we can say. Next, achievements of BRICS. Means the first one is CRA, that is contingent reserve arrangement. And that means it is a partnership of its member with the other financial area, with other country. In 6th BRICS summit, Brazil member country signed agreement creating a new development bank. That is Brazil 6th meeting has done. In that they have a agreement they signed. What is the agreement? New development bank should be achieved. And headquarters in the Shanghai, China 2015 they have launched it. Okay. Asian Development Bank and World Bank, you can say that one. And also it has a well-developed democratic development in the BRICS countries, increasing growth has increases. So it has a share of 43% of world population. Only 20, so far they achieved only 21% of global GDP, gross domestic product. So these are all about the lesson 8. Thank you.